Welcome to Retro Eric. Today we are testing this card, which gives us an AdLib card, a network card, and an XT-IDE based compact flash card, all three in one card. No wonder the card is called 3inONEder. This card is for portable Toshibas from the T1100 Plus to the T5200, from the mid-80s to the early 1990s. And I have to say that Armin from Conventional Memories did a fantastic job cramming three cards into one. Why have I never seen an ordinary ISA card with sound, disk and network? This is basically a standard ISA card, but with a very non-standard connector. In fact, the connector is so hard to come by that Armin says that when he runs out, he can no longer make these cards. The card is based on these three projects. The CF card portion of the board is based on Lotec's XT CF boards. The OPL3 sound card is based on ReSound OPL3 by Texelec. And the Ethernet portion is based on Monvurm's, I think, ISA 8090. First, I install the card in my Toshiba T1200 HD. The 1200 HD has a button for turning off the internal hard drive. And since my hard drive does not spin up, I always leave it off. Installing the card is super easy. I had a compact 128 megabit flash card from another computer. I inserted the card and the Toshiba booted straight up. There was nothing to it. That's how easy and great this card is. But on my T5200, I have more to share with you. So there is the focus in this video. My T5200 has an original 200 megabyte Connor hard drive, and I would very much like to replace it with a faster and less noisy option. And since we have an XT-IDE BIOS on the 3inONEder, we can use any IDE compatible disk option. I decided to go for this DOM or disk on module. My plan is to use this as the boot drive and the compact flash on the 3inONEder as an external device to easily copy things back and forth. Here we can see where the ISA slots and the Toshiba proprietary slot are located. Armin told me that if there is physically room, you can use both the 8 and 16-bit slot together with the 3inONEder. The Toshiba connector is basically just a way to connect to the ISA bus. Installing the card was easy. And as with my Toshiba 1200, it booted up from the CF card. I then used FDisk and formatted the disk on module and copy over some files. But I had to boot from floppy to make it the active partition. So I pressed F2 in the boot menu and chose to boot from floppy. I also ran a couple of speed tests. My compact flash card had a speed of 253 kilobytes per second, and the internal disk on module had 395 kilobytes per second. That's about 56% faster. I guess that the speed improvement from the disk on module is that the bus is 16-bit, but on the 3inONEder it's only 8-bit. But still a lot faster than the original Connor drive, I would imagine. Next step was to boot from the internal disk on module and try to improve the hard drive speed by using the XT-IDE BIOS with the 286 instruction set. So I went to Conventional Memory's webpage and downloaded the BIOS with the 286 instructions and probably configured to use the internal IDE as the boot device. Actually, I'm making this look easy. And it is. But before I found out that I could download a BIOS already configured for the 286 instructions and the internal IDE drive, I was mucking around with XT-IDE CFG, as I would with other XT-IDE solutions. Find an XT-IDE BIOS bin file and configure it with XT-IDE CFG util, the same ways as always, one might think, until you want to flash the BIOS. Then all you get is error messages. After a while, I figured out that the reason one cannot use XT-IDE CFG to change the BIOS on this 3inONEder card is that the EEPROM is not only the EEPROM for the XT-IDE BIOS, but also for other functions on the card. That is why you must use the flash utility on his webpage. If you want, you can open the bin file and make adjustments with XT-IDE CFG utility, but you have to choose to save those adjustments back to the bin file and then use the flash utility to flash the EEPROM. After installing the AT BIOS with support for 286 instructions, I did a new speed test. The compact flash card was now running at 513 kilobytes per second and the internal disk was 685 kilobytes per second. I am super happy with that speed. I wonder if the 386 version of the XT-IDE BIOS would improve the speed further. Using the AdLib card is as easy as it gets. Just start your game and choose AdLib. I have to say that the sound quality of this AdLib card is among the best I've ever heard, if not the best. The creator Armin commented that he is using high quality filter caps in the audio path to eliminate a lot of the background noise from old power supplies. Even the network card was easy to set up. I downloaded the NE-2000 driver from his webpage, added these two lines in my auto-exec bot, and now I have network support in Windows 3.1 and Arachne web browser for DOS. Well, so what do I think about this card? I think the card is marvelous. If I want to use it in my T1200, I just remembered to run the flash utility to flash the XT BIOS. When moving it back to my Toshiba 5200, I flash it with a AT BIOS with internal IDE boot disk support. That's it. I'm very happy with this card and I have no problem recommending it to anybody with a compatible portable Toshiba. Well, as always, I hope you liked the video, I hope you enjoyed watching it, and I hope you learned something while watching it. If you do, then you should subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of my videos. Thank you for watching.